Hi students, I welcome you all. How are you? I hope everyone are safe and good at home. Are you making this use of these holidays? Yes? Good. I am telling you to practice both reading and writing skills. Okay? Can you do it? Yes. I am Priya Srijan, teaching social science. First, I thank my management for providing me this wonderful opportunity to conduct an online class for our students. Overseas children, before going to the class, shall I ask you few questions? Are you all ready? Okay. Children, you are all safe in your home, right? How many members are in your home? Tell me. How many members are there in your home? There are three or more than three members, right? Who are the members? Tell me, who are the members? In some homes, father, mother and you, right? In some homes, father, mother, brother, you and sister. Right? In some homes, grandparents, father, mother, you and your sister and brother. Okay? This answer can be different, right? Okay. So, these members are belongs to your families, right? Good. So, now we are going to see the chapter families. So, based upon this topic, I will teach you subtitle, Introduction of Family, Relationship of Members in a Family, Different Types of Family. First, let me tell you an introduction of family. Okay? Children, we are all live in a family, right? So, do you know what is family? Family is a group of people who are related to one another, right? So, family is a group of people who are related to one another. So, what is the meaning of related? Related means connected, okay? So, we are all connected together. People in a family love and take care of one another, right? So, family is the first school where a child learns. So, as a child, you are a part of your family, right? So, who are your closest relatives? Your father and your mother, okay? So, your father and your mother are your parents, right? And also, there are many relatives in your family. Who are they? Grandfather, grandmother, father, mother, uncle, aunt, brothers, sisters, cousin sister and cousin brother. Okay, so let me tell you about your brothers and sisters. Children, you have elder brother and also younger brother. Elder brother and also younger brother. Likewise, you have elder sister and younger sister. So, what is the meaning of elder and younger? So, one who born before you, he is your elder brother. Okay? So, the elder brother means one who born before you, he is your elder brother. We can say elder brother means he is your big brother. And also younger brother. Younger brother means one who born after you. okay, one who born after you. So he is your small brother. Younger brother means small brother. Elder brother means big brother. Likewise, elder sister means big sister. Younger sister means small sister. Did you understand? Good. Now we will see relationship of members in the family. Okay, so children, already you studied relationship about members in your family. So it will be very interesting to learn. Okay, so when I am teaching, you have to repeat it. Right? Good. Relationship of members in a family. So your father's mother is your grandmother. Your father's father is your grandfather. Your mother's mother is your grandmother. Your mother's father is also your grandfather. Your father's brother is your uncle. Your father's sister is your aunt. Your mother's brother is also your uncle. Your mother's sister is also your aunt. Your parents' child, but not you. Who are they? Your sister or your brother? Right. Your uncles and aunts' children are your cousins. Good. I hope you are clear in this relationship. Yes? Good. So now we will see different types of families. So families can be classified into two types. Okay, families can be classified into two types. Nuclear families and joint families. Okay, families can be classified into two types. Nuclear families, the second one is joint families. Again, the nuclear family is classified into one, that is called as small family. The joint family is classified into one, that is called as big family. So we can say the nuclear families are also known as small family, and the joint families are also called as big family. Okay, so now let me tell you each topic in detail. Okay, so first I will tell you about small family. So children, now you look at this picture. This is a small family. Okay, here you can see father, mother and their child. So how many people are in this family? There are three members. Okay, so these three members are in a small family. So what is small family? A family which parent and their child or two children are called small family. Okay, so they are all living together in the same house. Okay, they are all living together in the same house. This family has very less needs. They live happily and also they can be satisfied easier. Okay, so tell me, are you in a small family? Yes? Good. Next, we will see joint family. So now you look at this picture. Here you can see grandfather, grandmother, father, mother, uncle, aunt, children. Okay, so in this joint family, a family that has more than one set of parents, grandparents, uncle, aunt, parents, sister, brother, all living together in the same house, they are called joint family. Okay, so many generation in this family living together only in joint family, right? In the beginning, the people who are lived in joint family, okay, in an olden days, the people lived together in joint family. Then what will happen? They left their home to look for a job or to study. They were made a small family. Okay. So in this joint family, it can be very fun to live in this family, right? If you have uncle, aunt, grandparents, brothers, sisters, everyone together in your home, you will be playing, smiling, laughing, making noise in your home, fighting, and sometimes quarreling and crying. So everything you are doing in your joint family, okay? So it can be very fun to live in the joint family, all right? So let me tell you a story which is related to joint family. Do you like to hear a story? Yes? Good. Okay, listen to me. In a village, there was an old man. He has 4 sons. One day, he called his sons and gave each of them a stick and asked them to break the sticks, and they also broke it. Next day, again the old man called his sons and asked them to break a bundle of sticks at the same time, but no one could do it. Why? Because unity is strength. If they joined together and try to break the bundle, means they can do it. But if they are separated, they couldn't able to do. Okay? Likewise, in a family, if you are joined together, it's a strength for your family. Right? Good. Now, let me tell you a big family. So big family also, a parent and 2 or more children join together in the same house. They are called as big family. Okay. What is big family? A family which having more than 2 children. They are called as big family. Okay. Is it clear for you? What are the differences between nuclear family and joint family? Let me tell you the point. The first point, nuclear family is also called as small family. And the joint family is also called as big family. Then, in the small family, it is a happy family. A parent and their 1 or 2 children living together in the same house, that is small family. And about the big family, a family which has parent and their 2 or more children living together in the same house, they are called big family. Okay, so now we will see single parent family. Okay, now we will see single parent family. Single parent family. Okay. So, in this family, there is only one parent, okay? A mother or a father. they are looking after a child or a children, they are called as single parent family. Did you understand what is meant by single parent family? In a family, there is only one parent, even if it is a mother or it is a father, okay, who are taking care of their child or children. They are the single parent family, right? So in this family, there is only one parent. So if they want to go for work, they have to get support from their relatives or friends to see their children. Yes, right. Because no one is there to take care of their children. Right? Good. So now we will see how does a family grows and changes. Okay? How does a family grows and changes? Family, how does a family grows and changes? See here, the families do not remain the same. Correct? Yes, no, it will be different. For example, some parents, they have only one child and some others have more than one child, right? So when a baby comes into the family grows and also it gets some changes, right? For an example, if you are an only one child in your home, when a small baby comes to your house, you will get a brother or sister, okay? So, the brothers and sisters are your siblings, right? Good. Who are your siblings? Tell me, who are your siblings? Siblings means brothers and sisters, okay? If you have brothers and sisters, if you have brothers and sisters, they are your siblings. Is it clear? Next, we will see generation in a family. Okay? Next, we will see generation in a family. So here, many generations living together in the joint family. Okay? Many generations of people living together in the joint family. And here, the grandparents are of first generation. Okay? The grandparents are of first generation. And their children are of second generation. There comes your parents, right? And their grandchildren are of third generation. There comes you. So, now I will tell you what is generation. Generation means the people who were born at about the same time. Understood? Generation means the people who were born at about the same time. Which means all the people who are in the same family at the same age, they are called generation. Right? Good. Now we will see working parents. Okay, ma? Now we will see working parents. So everyone works, right? People in your family also works, correct? So they may work household works such as cooking, mopping, sweeping, cleaning the clothes, cleaning the vessels, gardening, etc. And some parents, they may work at home on laptop, computers, etc. And some parents, they may go out to other places like offices, colleges, schools, bank, police station, etc. Right? And also, how do they travel to the office? How do they travel to office? They will travel by using their own transport or other RLs. They will get bus, car, auto rickshaw, two-wheeler, etc. Right? Okay. These working parents, they have to plan their plan to spend their time with their family, right? Yes. In some families, only father will go out to work. The mother stay at home and look after the children, and she is taking care of you and your family, right? In some family, both mother and father going out to work. And the single parent family also, the single parent, they are also going out to work. So in that situations, they have to find another one person to look for their child or children. Right? Okay, children. Now we will see the way to help your parents. Okay? Now we will see the way to help your parents. So, which are the ways you can help your parents? I will tell you. If there is an elderly person in your home, which means your grandparents are in your home, you can help by giving medicine, food, water on time, right? Can you do it? Okay. And if there is a smaller person in your home, smaller, I mean your brothers, younger brother or younger sisters are in your home, you can love and give care of them. Okay. And how can you help your father? If your father is going out to work, you can help him by giving mobile phone, kerchief, lunch carrier, specs, etc. And also, how can you help your mother? You can help your mother by giving water to clean the vegetables, watering the plant. You can be quiet in your home. Stay quiet. So these are the things it is helping your mother, right? And also, you can help your small brother or sister by doing their homeworks. So these are the ways you can help your family members. Right? Good. Can you do it? Good. So now we will see advantages of family. Okay? Now we will see advantages of family. Advantages of family. So, what is the meaning of advantage? Advantage means, what is the meaning of advantage? Advantages means importance. Okay? So, here we are going to learn about importance of family. Right? Good. So, the first, already I told you, family is the first school where a child learns. Right? So, before joining the school, you are all learning some good habits and good behavior from your family, right? After coming to school, you are achieving many more skills, yes? And also, you get some discipline to maintain your character from the school, right? Good. And whatever you are asking to your parents, they are ready to give you. And also your parents provides you food, shelter, clothes and toys, right? And also you are a child, you are loving your parent, and the parents also giving the same love to you. Next, you must love your brother and sisters and also your family members. You must respect your elders and also your family members. Okay? Then if you have your joys and your sorrows, everything you can share to your family members. So we all live in a family. So if we are going to any festivals, that is, if you go with your family, it is very happy to us, right? Yes. So let us discuss with an exercise. Okay, so first one, fill in the blanks. I have a child named Kripa. She is my, what is the answer? I have a child named Kripa. She is my, good, daughter. Uncle Vivek has two children. They are my, Uncle Vivek has two children. They are my, good, cousins. Do you have cousins? Yes? Okay, good. I am Mary's son. She is my, I am Mary's son. She is my mother, right? Next, we can see, right, true or false, okay? First one, brothers and sisters are siblings. What will be the answer? Tell me, brothers and sisters are siblings. Is it true or false? Good, true. Number two, nuclear family is a big family. Nuclear family is a big family. Is it true? No, it's false. Why is it false? Because nuclear family is a small family, right? Good. Now, I will give you one assignment, okay? So, today's assignment is draw a family tree and write down the members in your family. Okay? What's the assignment of today's class? Draw a family tree and write down the members in your family. Okay? Okay, children. Now, let me summarize the topic. I hope you are all understand this lesson. So once again, I will tell you the important points from this lesson. Okay, so what are the topics we have learned today? What is family? Family means it's a group of people who are related with one another, right? So parents and their children make a family. Then the relationship of members in a family, different types of families we learned. How does a family grows and also how does it changes we learned. Then advantages of family, then working parents, then what are the ways you can help your parents. So these all the topics we have learned today. Yes? Okay, children. So before leaving the session, I request all my dearest students to stay inside your house and also stay safe. Okay? So we will meet in the next class. Thank you, students. Take care. Bye-bye.